I'm down. Let's go to your room.
What did your husband tell you about his participation in the war in France?
He commanded SEP, which was the Portuguese army. They went by sea and disembarked in Brest around 1917 or 18. Then he participated in war. But he wasn't allowed to come to Portugal when his father died. He asked for a license to visit his widow mother and sister, but they wouldn't allow him, so he just came later. There was an epidemic in Porto, so he was just working there. Then he returned to France.
Okay, and that's when the German army attacked at the 9th of April, known as Lisboa Battle?
Yes, in the 9th of April, they thought they were going to be substituted. They would return to Portugal and then they would be replaced. But at dawn of that day, they were attacked by an intense bombarding from the German army. They didn't know what to expect, and so it continued on and on. And they attacked the English and Portuguese zone at west, I think.
What? So the Portuguese fought beside the English?
Yep, but let me tell you that no one wanted the Portuguese to join the war, not even the soldiers. The government recruited people to go to war to improve the view other countries had about them.
The Germans attacked the Portuguese area, which was the weakest, and they weren't wrong. By opening a hole, that's exactly what a strategist told everyone. They wanted to open a hole because the Portuguese zone was poor in machinery, there were really few officials, and also all the soldiers were demoralized. And probably they got to know this due to spying.
Oh, I read somewhere that the trenches were so filthy that a lot of soldiers would be sick from the conditions. They didn't have much sleep or much variety of food, just corn beef. They also lived with rats, fresh humidity, rain and cold. Not to talk about the fear and the pressure of being near death, and not knowing if they would wake up the following day.
That's so sad. The Portuguese even created a song for the rats in order to have their minds occupied and not worrying.
So, the German army started bombarding the Portuguese trench on the 9th of April. What happened next?
The bombarding first initiated early that day, and it ceded from the afternoon and on. And then there was the infantry and the Portuguese battled while they had ammunition, which wasn't that much. So, some of them gave up, the ones who were alive. There were also the ones that were capable to fight, and still there, they continued to fight, which was the case of Miyaj. But I think my husband didn't know him.
This was a really important figure. There is even a movie that's about to premiere about him. His name was Aníbal Miyaj, and during Lali's battle, he fought the German alone with his machine gun Luis. The way he allowed many of his companions, English and Portuguese, protect themselves in defensive zones. He confronted German soldiers, a lot of them in the trenches, and he even saved a Scottish doctor who was drowning in a swamp.
Whoa, that's what I call a hero in the case.
On the 11th day, the Germans stopped the attack, and my husband was still there with his friend Jean-Christophe.
Did your husband suffer any type of injury during the German attack?
Yes, due to the toxic gas used by the Germans. Actually, it was a new weapon, so they were desperate when they first felt the symptoms. My husband had his respiratory system damaged, and his partner, Jean-Christophe, was blind. But then they got their organisms reconstituted, but it was a really new weapon, so they didn't know what to expect from it. They thought they were dying, and they were old friends from high school and university, so it just made things worse.
What did your husband recall about the behavior of his direct command from his official who orientated him during all his battle?
Who was in charge of the health unity was a colonel, which I think my husband told me the name, or maybe he didn't. But yeah, and my husband understood the fact of someone running away from war, because for him it's like so unhuman, so awful, so horrendous, that a man never would come back to what he was before, even if he didn't fight or kill anyone. So he thought that it would be even worse if someone killed or was killed.
But we are also talking about the behavior of your husband's direct command during the Lally's battle.
Oh yeah, that colonel ran away and took all the medicine. So when this happened, there wasn't actually an official to reward my husband or Jean-Christophe, his friend, because there weren't actually proof that they were there helping all the soldiers, because he ran away after all.
That horror your husband had against war, how did it reflect in his attitude towards the use of weapons in the front?
He thought that killing for political reasons was stupid. He was a pacifist by nature and formation. You can't conceive a doctor that walks around killing people, right? So the doctor feels a lot more of the futility of wars. He assisted the injured not only on the trenches but also on the no man's land. When he was carrying the stretcher bearers. And sometimes he would even find doctors from the opposite side, from the German army.
When he went to the no man's land, did he bring any weapons with him?
No. He refused to use it because he thought he was a doctor and the doctor's mission is to save someone, not to kill. So he just thought that I'm a doctor, I'm not a warrior, and I'm here, and so I'll put my gun aside.
Did your husband tell you something about self-mutilation from the soldiers, about diseases that they presented so they could be dismissed from duty?
No, he was really discreet. Speaking in an impersonal way, he could tell about some soldiers, but he wasn't reporting anyone who was sick. It's not a professional secret, as anybody knew. But no, he didn't speak to me about that.
Okay. And about the general environment of the troops with whom he contacted with, did they want to fight?
Most of them were peasants, so they were obligated to go to war and enlist to the army. Of course, they didn't like to apply for that because they were far away from their family, from their roots, from their land. From their friends. He actually was pity of them.
Whoa. I know war was awful, but I didn't know the conditions the soldiers had to fight in.
Yeah, violence leads to violence. There's nothing good about it.
Well, we definitely need to do this more often. Now I must go home. I'm sure my mom is worried sick.
Okay, see you tomorrow.
Yeah.